Hello, welcome to Transformation Station. This is Scott speaking to you, and I'm getting ready to mill a 10-foot log on my OS-23 Frontier by Norwood. This video, I take off a slab, probably a couple boards. Now, I actually don't have the equipment to do the fancy videos yet and splice and everything, so I'm not going to shoot a full video of the entire log, but I did want to start with this. And we can progress as we go along. So I hope you enjoy this little video from Transformation Station, Scott in West Virginia, getting ready to mill a poplar log on my OS-23 Frontier. And I want to do it in real time. So I hope you enjoy. Actually, I had to bump the log down a little bit further. I did it once, and it's about a 10.3-inch log. I had to bump it down just a little bit further because the blade is basically on the end there. Couldn't finish that final cut. Get back at it here. know that's the first board there. There's still a partial board left in that, so I like to save all that I can and not waste wood. Working one of these manual sawmills where you got to do all the adjusting and changing and flipping that all by yourself, makes it really nice if you can get somebody to help you. Makes the whole process go a lot smoother and be able to perform about 8 logs or so through the day. time, I'm going to go ahead and take my log post out of the back. They're now too high. When I built this sled for the base of this sawmill, I built it out of 6x6 treated, and I did not pay attention to where the beams underneath treated versus the log post on the actual mill, and because of that, it wants to land right on top of those beams underneath that I built. So if you ever build a 6x6 treated sled for one of these sawmills, make sure you offset it from where the log post falls, and it'll go down the ground, all the way to the ground. Because the way I did it, I'm gonna have to take them out now. But once you cut three sides on the log, you're now ready for the cam dogs and the little risers on the back. You no longer need a log post. You just bump it up against those little risers on the back. You can cut down to 1 inch, which is pretty awesome. And then you can use your cam dogs, and then you're good to go. So once you slab three times, flip it up, take your last one, take the log post out, you're good for the rest of the log. Lever there, I just moved a silver L right underneath the attention handle. That's to adjust the width of your cut. Try to keep that tight as you go through the process of cutting your log, so your blade won't have so much room to waver and have issues and have wavy cuts. Just a little tip. wood, but it's spalted, it's aged. Makes great interior boards. You want to be careful where you would use it on an exterior situation, but it's fabulous for interior. You get all these lines and wormhole marks, and just makes beautiful wood. Once you throw some polyurethane on it or whatever. Poplar is an awesome wood. It has green, purple, multiple colors in it. Very beautiful. Poplar here, really rich and yellow. I decided to go ahead and cut this an inch, use it for an exterior board, and get them to pretty good solid part. this log has laid for a while and been aged. So it's been very seasoned, so the rest of it will dry out real fast and be able to use it quickly. This particular sawmill comes in a 7.5 and 10 horse motor, but I would strongly urge you, if you're going to buy an OS23 Frontier, buy the 10 horse motor. It's only a $200 upgrade and well worth it. Gives you an extra 2.5 horsepower, and you'd be glad you did once you start sawing. Going to run the video for the entire log, but things are going pretty good. I think I'll just run the video all the way to the end, make you a nice one. satisfying to mill and create your own lumber. This is a 10 horse, but you gotta treat it like a lady. You gotta just ease it through. You cannot push. If you push, it'll create problems in your lumber. If you treat it like a lady, it'll give you back some love.